Next, we're going to talk about data ecosystems. And so there's going to be three areas of data that this article is going to cover. Think beyond the entrepreneur or the independent seller that just has a small Shopify store and they're drop shipping. Think of a large corporation retailer such as Target or Home Depot. They're going to have a gigantic organization with maybe thousands of employees with different departments that handle accounting, sourcing, merchandising, HR, sales, and each one of them have their own specific needs, and they need to collaborate with internal organization data, the first ecosystem. There's going to be acronyms that we need to familiarize ourselves. And so the first acronym we're going to come across is an ERP, stands for Enterprise Resource Planning. And some of the platforms that offer ERPs are software such as Microsoft Dynamics 365, SAP, Oracle NetSuite, Epicor, and even QuickBooks is a form of an ERP. Think about, if you're familiar with QuickBooks, you can run your invoicing, accounting, your inventory, sales, and customer data all out of QuickBooks. Here in the image, it shows the different facets of an ERP. And that's where you're going to have manufacturing, product, inventory, service, purchasing, human resources, sales, financials, CRM, et cetera. But some module inside of that ERP is going to hold inventory data. It's going to have a catalog, or there's going to be other systems of where that data is going to be hosted as well. And that we're going to get to next. Another acronym would be an MDM, Master Data Management. It's like a master file of product data or contact lists. Then there's digital asset management, where they have a library of digital assets like photos, video, stuff like that, that employees can collaborate over those digital assets and have a library where they're saved and hosted. And then we're going to talk more about internal product data. So from going to organizational data to more about the product data itself, there is product data management, product lifecycle management, and product information management. And I'm going to focus mostly on product information management. But here, like PDP, could even be down to the files for the CAD building of certain products. So there's going to be data out there that is more about the manufacturing of the product and stuff like that. I want to focus on a PIM, a product information management system. It's their golden record. It's where they keep their main source of product content that can be syndicated out to other channels. And there's some examples of softwares that do that here. Then we get to the customer-facing data, and that's where Godatafeed comes into picture. So there's some other acronyms like product experience management, product information distribution services, and then feed management. Godatafeed could fit into any one of these definitions. It's essentially the idea of syndicating or distributing your product to different channels for your customers to purchase or click on an ad or to learn about your products.